Good morning, traders. Today we want to talk about lame and improve US dollar, Canadian dollar, and FX price action trading. Lame and improve US dollar, Canadian dollar, and FX price action trading. We are a monthly chart of the US dollar, Canadian dollar. And as you can see on these charts, all right, this currency went up. Okay, bear with me. I want to use a Fibonacci extensions for the price action from here all the way up here. So price went up, I'm on the monthly chart, went up all the way here, all right? And I want to use Fibonacci extension. The most powerful Fibonacci extension is the 138.2% Fibonacci extension level. I'm going to color it now into pink. So please, the beautiful ladies that can trade better than men. So as you can see, in 2009, was it 2009? Yes, 2009. The US dollar, Canadian dollar has peaked right here in the zone of 12980. That's the resistance in that zone. It's not exact high, but in the zone of 12980. So 2009 was the peak. So price went down from that point onward. People sold it and it went down and finally recovered and start going down from 2013 and reaches that resistance level right here. And people sold it again, so the bullish traders were willing to take profit as the price reaches the level 12980. Finally, the price breaks above that level, break above and retest. We see the our retest. That's what we are looking for. Break above, retest. First bullish candle, see bar, implement a top down trading method. Price breaks above the prior high. The first challenge for the bullish progression is which level? The 138.2% Fibonacci extension level. So if you do not know what I'm talking about here, relating to Fibonacci extension level, you want to subscribe today, right now, to Day Pro Traders YouTube channel, where I am busy recording videos, sharing a powerful Fibonacci trading strategy. We have now more than 260 videos there, if I'm correct. And this year, I've shared some of my best Fibonacci trading strategies. So feel free to subscribe to that channel so you may understand. So you know what? As the price start going down here, it's going now from 2013, professional Forex traders or FX traders already have this line 12980 on their chart. And also the level of 142.110 on their chart. The 138.2% Fibonacci extension level is already on their chart. And they know exactly what to do. So as the price start going up, as a day trader, price arriving at the station, at the terminus, all right? All right? So this was the previous high. Now it's going up. So we are now again in the same place. So what has happened here? People sold it. It was going up, it reaches this level, people sold it. The market does not forget. Now here it is start going up again, reaching the same level. What has happened there? They sold it. You will be prepared as a day trader looking for sell signal here, sell trading setup, and then you will implement a top-down trading method to trade it. If you are swing trader also here, and for a few months, it didn't go down in a straight line. So see here. So if you were buying, this is what we are talking about. If you want to sell, you want to see a bullish candle. You want to buy, you want to see first a bearish candle. So it went down, so you are buying here, which is completely a bit crazy. You need to be careful. Now bounce up, now they sold it. Bounce up again, and then they sold it, and then finally ran off. Alright? So now they sold it here because of what has happened before. They also know that the 138.2% level is the challenge for this bullish momentum. It breaks above, retest, that's how we buy, break above a normal horizontal key level or a break above a trend line, retest, turn around. Here it is, implement a top-down trading method a multiple time frame trading method. So a top-down trading method is equal to multiple time frame trading method. All right, because a lot of traders notice that people are searching more for multiple time frame trading method, but there are videos about top-down trading method. So if you are looking for multiple time frame trading method, search for multiple time frame trading method, and also search for top-down trading method. All right, and you will see videos. All right, because I record a video at 2-4 stock trader, I talk about multiple time frame trading method. I notice that a lot of traders are watching that video. I record another video about how to use a top-down trading method on a monthly chart, and people don't know what I'm talking about. But it's exactly the same thing. All right, so here we are. So the prime went up to the 138.2% Fibonacci extension, the holy place. So now, nothing holy about this, all right? Okay, just a powerful Fibonacci level, okay? Just powerful, okay? You look at this, look at this beautiful setup. The inverted hammer and the bearish candlestick bar at 138.2% Fibonacci retracement level. Do you know this candlestick pattern? Inverted hammer and a bearish candlestick that is closed. The following month, well, is an invitation to sell. It's a bearish party. It's a bearish barbecue in the financial market. So the bearish traders were enjoying themselves for 2 months. Boom, down, boom, down. All right? The inverse is also true when we see a hammer and a bullish candlestick bar. All right? So this is an inverted hammer. So if we flip it upside down, you'll have the real hammer and a bullish candlestick. It is okay. A bullish candlestick pattern. But what usually takes place? I will be recording videos about candlestick pattern because I see a lot of videos about candlestick pattern. But there is something that we need to talk about more. I'm not saying that those videos were useless, but traders are still making mistakes because when we are talking about a pattern, what have I said? The location of the pattern. Where does the pattern form? You see this pattern here? It's a bearish candlestick pattern at a resistance level. That's where it should be. So I am interested in this one. If it was in a wrong place, I will not. So whenever you hear the word pattern, think of location. All right? So they sold it here, and the price is pulling back now. So you may say to me, Joe, talk to me. What do we need to do now? So price, they sold it here, price pulled back a bit. The minimum price move, I'm talking about another price principle, which I've been talking about, the free Elliott Wave trading system, a 2-4 Elliott Wave YouTube channel. The minimum price move, check that video, the first free Elliott Wave, okay, trading system, all right? A 2-4 Elliott Wave YouTube channel. The minimum price move is free. 1, 2. There's a high chance that this US dollar, Canadian dollar, has a high chance to pull back one more time to this level here. Because this was the low, so the price found a support before going up to the 138.2% level. You see this level? Pull up. This is a strong support level because from here, it breaks that resistance that it couldn't break here. So it's a very, very important support level. In fact, I will highlight it for you so you may note it down. Those who are using a trading platform on their smartphone, talk about this also before. A 2-4 Forex trader, what's going on with trading on your smartphone, what you need to be aware of. I think I titled that video, What a Smartphone Has Got to Do with FX Trading, something like that, at 244 Forex Trader YouTube channel. So that level is 11897. 11897, okay? So there is a high chance that the USD cards, as we like to call it, has a high chance to continue to go down, will find a resistance somewhere in this zone and come back down to this level 11897. And if he reaches that level and finds support, he has a high sound to go back up. doesn't mean that that's exactly what he will definitely do, but there is a high chance he may do that. If he breaks below it, all right, and retests that level of 11897, and we see the first bearish candlestick bar, what do we need to do? We will implement a top-down trading method, and we will sell, because we want to be ready to buy, and we want to be ready to sell. We are not fixated to buy. We are just free traders, all right? if it's giving us a bullish signal, we buy. We have a bearish signal, we sell. Okay? So, the point I want to make, there is a price structure in place, all right, which I've been talking about before. The price structure will determine the appropriate strategy that we must deploy, yes or no? So you may say, George, what are we talking about here? I'm new to your channel. So the price is was in a rising channel. So connecting this low and this low here, I draw my first line, which I'm going to color now into red. Here it is. This point and this point allow me to connect to draw my red line. And I just choose one point here to draw a line that is parallel to my red line. Now I have my first channel. So, the US dollar, Canadian dollar was in a bullish trend, in a rising channel. Now, looking at the current price structure, the price is out of that red channel and was trying, will it continue to go all the way to retest the channel? Because now it's going horizontal here. Will it go all the way to retest the channel before coming down to 11897? We leave it here as it is now because it's going horizontal now. It's a continuation pattern going down horizontal. All right. Will it find a resistance and push it down to 11897. Some trader may say to me, "Joe, you just say to me to sell, and I will sell. And I'll keep my fingers crossed. Hopefully everything will work well." It's up to you. It's up to you. All right? It's up to you. All right? It's up to you. Look for a trading setup, and then implement a top-down trading method to trade it. Okay? All right? Multiple time-frame trading method to trade it. So price out of the channel, we are multi-talented FS traders. We know about market geometry. Project that channel in the direction of the price. And we draw a line that is parallel to our channel again. Now we have our projected channel in place. Hold on a second as I'm adjusting my channel to make sure that everything is correct. All right. So if you project our channel the first time, it's bringing us here. So find a resistance here. Watch this red trend line here. There's a support on the edge of the channel. If it breaks above it, we project that channel again. We measure the width of the channel. And we project it again below. So we have our line ready on the chart. All right, this is about lane. And improve US dollar, Canadian dollar, and FX price action trading. So you can see here, I have a stochastic on my chart, but we are looking at the price action alone. Price went up, display a high, pull back, breaks above the prior high, price hits the 138.2% Fibonacci extension level, is pulling back. We are applying the minimum price move, which is free, expecting the price. Our expectation is not exactly what the price must do, but if the price fulfilling our expectation, we'll take advantage of it. Using a top-down trading method or a multiple time frame trading method. Very simple. Now, we are also using the market geometry. The price was in the rising channel. The current price structure is bearish because the price is out of the bearish channel. Now, okay, we will retest the edge of it and then pull back to retest the lower part of our first projected channel. If it's out of our first projected channel, we'll measure the width of our original channel and project it again in the direction of the price, and we'll have our third channel somewhere here. In my view, the US dollar, Canadian dollar has a high chance to find a resistance somewhere in this zone and then pull back okay, to retest the level of 11897 that remain to be seen if the short-term equilibrium, have I drawn the short-term equilibrium price level for this? Yes, the short-term equilibrium price level is corresponding exactly to the level 12980. That level will remain in place for the next 2 weeks or so. So maximum 3 weeks, day traders and swing traders must watch the level 12980 if they are trading the US dollar, Canadian dollar. If one is trading Forex or FX, one must constantly pay attention to the economy news. Remember, I say to traders, which I'm talking about all the time, that for a Forex trader, it's better not to trade between the 1st and the 8th of each month, and also between the 15th and the 20th of each month. The market environment will influence, okay, our trading. So we want to trade during the best period of the market. And between the 1st and the 8th of each month is quite challenging to trade, and also between the 15th and the 20th. So for some traders, in order to improve their FX trading, all they have to do is to avoid trading during those times, and it will be all right, okay? But if you want to trade, okay, during those periods, you want to use a minimum, you want to control the risk, all right, and be very, very defensive. A lot of Forex traders have been trading for years, and they don't understand the Forex market. It's not that they cannot trade, but there are a few things that they are missing out on. So they know how to use MACD, stochastic, and they are not going anywhere because, first, they are ignoring the economy news. And I will say to them, if you do not want to pay attention to the economy news, do not trade Forex. Trade stock, trade commodity, trade something else. Don't trade Forex if you don't want to pay attention to the economy news, because you're going to, okay, economy news are coming in all the time. Tall candlestick here, long candlestick bar there. High impact economy news between 1 p.m. London time until New York is open. So from 1 p.m. to 2:30 p.m. London time, this is another period that traders trade when economy news are released. All right. So for some traders, it's just to know when I should come into the market. Okay. So you don't want something to stand against you, all right? Another thing also, you don't want somebody else to trade against you, all right? So you don't want, okay, the high-impact economy news to work against you. So what should you do? Wait for the economy news to be released, or don't trade at all that day. Sometimes you see economy news are released on Friday, all right? And then people, after the news, people try to trade it, and the market is not budging, they lose money. And then people will try to trade again, okay, Sunday night when Forex is marked open. And then you woke up Monday morning and London is open. The setup is beautifully set now. And you just go there, you trade it. So choose the best time to come into the market, all right, and then trade, okay. And when you are trading, look for a high probability trading setup. And then implement multiple time frame trading method. Work on it consistently. You have a trading method? Well, you want to buy at a support level. You want to sell at a resistance level. The key levels, that's where the action is taking place. Break a bull, retest, candlestick is closed, implement a top-down trading method to trade it. The price structure will determine the strategy that we must deploy. Here we can see that the price is out of a rising channel. Here, okay, everybody, professional, are expecting that. Okay, they are expecting a rally up and then boom down. If you find a resistance here, boom down. Okay, the price structure will determine the appropriate strategy that we might deploy. What is happening here? The price went up from this high and then went to the 138.2% level, found a resistance. This is the challenge for the bullish progression. All right, so but it did find a support here and it break this resistance. So in normal condition, they will say, okay, let's bring it back here to this level, 11897, and see whether, for one more time, if we push it, we'll break above this resistance here. All right? Because in normal condition, as it breaks above, okay, the prior high, and it starts pulling back, a lot of breakout traders will be buying here, so they are expecting it to go back. So break above the level 12980 and then retest and turn around. But we did not have any turnaround. That's what I said to you. Retest and the first bullish candlestick bar, and then implement a top-down trading method. So he breaks above it, the level of 12980. He retests it, which is great, but we did not have any bullish candlestick that was close here. If we did, then we implement a top-down trading method. So if you're on a monthly chart, you can't wait till that candlestick bar is closed bullishly. At least you can use a weekly chart or whatever, that candlestick bar to close, and then from there, top-down trading method to control the risk. Don't just buy, okay, like ordinary technical traders. It makes sense? This is about learn and improve US dollar, Canadian dollar, and FX price action trading. So here you can see that now the stochastic is oversold right here. But there is a price structure in place. We want it 1, 2, 3, and then the stochastic will become more interesting. The oversold here will become more interesting because the minimum price move is free, possible reversal after minimum price free. So at that point in time, if it reaches this level of 11897, this is our warning line. We'll say priority to bullish signal above 11897 and priority to bearish signal below. Then we implement a top-down trading method to trade it. As it's going up, we are watching the this trend line here, you see. By combining, you see, the market geometry and everything else that we know, okay? So sometimes traders do not use that, so you are buying here. If you don't know there is a resistance there, that's a trend line there. So you watch that level, it must break above it. And there's another level here, 12980, and it's going up, it's looking for better resistance level one step at a time. It's coming down, it's looking for better support level. The red trend line here, the 11897, and then below it we have here. Do not ignore the media line of our second projected channel. Alright, is it too much for you? Okay, take it one step at a time and work on it gradually, okay? So one cannot learn everything one day. So put it into use, test it, practice, develop the skills and the experience. So you will be facing challenges. So the experience will come with losing trade, alright? Winning trade, alright? Willingness to know and breaking through the challenges and moving forward. And then you are maturing and learning. Okay? That's the key point. But the bottom line is not to lose. If you are losing, stop. Alright? Don't lose. Don't throw money away. Don't lose. Be very, very defensive. Alright? And know your best trading setup and focus on those. And work only with those that are working for you. Okay? So, in a business, they are talking about scaling. So they have a product that is selling more, that is making money. So they will scale that product. All right. So for traders, we don't talk about scaling. They talk about know your setup and trade your setup. So your high probability trading setup that you know, that you understand, that is working for you, you just keep trading it. Some traders trade only gap up and gap down stocks. So, all right. So they scan for stock that gap up, gap down. They know how to trade them. They know how to recognize, okay, exhaustion gap, continuation gap, breakaway gap, all right? And then they trade only gap stocks, all right? Because they understand it, okay? What is your best trading setup, all right? So that's what the question. You are interviewing somebody to become a trader. Ask them what's your three favorite trading setup that you like. If they can't tell you that in 3 minutes, you have a problem. All right, you have a problem. He has to go back to school and learn how to trade. All right, this is the end of the tutorial about learn and improve US dollar, Canadian dollar, and FX price action trading. I hope you'll find it useful and we put it to use, okay, to improve your FX price action trading. We are the TSTW 24 traders talking about learn and improve US dollar, Canadian dollar, and FX price action trading. If you have any question or suggestion, put in a comment section. And in due course, I will be busy recording another video to answer your specific question. Happy trading to you all and speak to you soon.